right here in Warrensburg. I remember that. Yes, that did happen.
Amen.
For those who would somehow say that type of thing didn't happen. Yes, it did.
Amen.
I remember the Civil Rights March, Washington, in August 28th, 1963, in which he had the Have a Dream speech and the effort to push for equality and educational opportunities for all in this nation. Ending in the Civil Rights Act of 1964, signed by President Lyndon Baines Johnson. Mm-hmm. As a young man, I was 21 years old. I still remember the subsequent assassination of Dr. King at the Lorraine Motel in Memphis, Tennessee. Early on the morning of April the 4th, 1968, he was 39 years old. After telling the sanitation workers of Memphis the night before, I might not get there with you, but we will get to the promised land.
Amen, yes.
That never became more evident to me when 2 years ago, and he's here tonight, stand up Jerry, Jerry Krause and I went on a Sankofa journey, took a little trip down to Birmingham and down to Montgomery and to Jackson, Mississippi. Retrace the steps of some of the things that happened along the trail for Dr. King. We ended up in Memphis, Tennessee, at the Lorraine Motel on a rainy night. I think it was a Super Bowl Sunday. I will never forget the impact that had on me. Stand at that motel, look up and see where Dr. King had stood, and his life was taken that night. The verses of the opening scriptures I read to you tonight, they take on a whole new meaning when we consider the life of Dr. King. You see, Dr. King, foremost and more than anything, was a Baptist preacher. And we sometimes put him in a different light than the fact that he was a preacher.
Yes.
And he believed that it was important that we consider our relationship with Jesus Christ,
yes,
who is Lord and Master of our soul. And it's the rock on whom we must stand if we are to be reconciled back to God and walk in the perfection of God's standard, which is how we treat one another. Dr. King believed that life is filled with complexities, as you find in Ephesians, the 6th chapter. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Yes.
We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed.
All right.
We're perplexed,
yes,
but not in despair.
Amen.
Persecuted,
but not
forsaken.
Amen.
Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our bodies. That has a special meaning for me, because in other words, Dr. King's death as a martyr for the cause of justice and equality of all mankind fulfilled the words of the scripture in his own life. One of his quotes, he said, "The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands in times of challenge and controversy."
All right.
Yes, equality and education still matter in this day and time. And let us not forget that Dr. King gave his life that others might reap the benefits of living in a society where everyone has an equal opportunity for success. Everyone, regardless of race,
all right,
creed, or color,
yes,
should have an equal opportunity for justice and a free and equal education.
Amen.
Yet we live in a day and time when equality and educational justice are being questioned.
Yes.
As not needed or an encroachment on the rights of others. This in turn leads to efforts to dismantle what Dr. King stood and died for. Creates an atmosphere of distrust, fear, and persecution. Like the quote, one of his quotes, he said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere."
Uh-huh.
Like the way the scripture put it, "See then that ye walk circumspectly." power of his might, and let us not be weary in well-doing.
Right.
For in due season we shall reap if we faint not. I like this little excerpt I found from February the 4th, 2 months before Dr. King died in Memphis. This was at the Ebenezer Baptist Church, speaking about how he wished to be remembered after his death. And this is what Dr. King said. I'd like somebody to mention that day that Martin Luther King Jr. tried to give his life serving others. I'd like for somebody to say that day that Martin Luther King Jr. tried to love somebody. I want you to say that day that I tried to be right on the question of the Vietnam War. I want you to be able to say that day that I did try to feed the hungry. I want you to be able to say that day that I did try in my life to clothe those who were naked. I want you to say on that day that I did try in my life to visit those who were in prison. I want you to say that I tried to love and serve humanity.
Yes.
Yes, if you want to say that I was a drum major, say that I was a drum major for justice.
Right.
Say that I was a drum major for peace.
Yes.
I was a drum major for righteousness. And all the other shallow things will not matter. I won't have any money to leave behind. Won't have the fine and luxurious things of life to leave behind. But I just want to leave a committed life behind. And I'd like to close with this quote. When I talk about Martin Luther King, it really hits me. I consider him a great man.
Yes, yes.
When I look back on my life and I think about all the things that today are different because of what one man put himself out there to do.
Yes,
yes. It wasn't just a black thing. It started off a black thing, but it ended up a thing for everybody.
All right. Amen.
You see, when I'm in bondage, you're in bondage too.
All right.
To how can we be free if there's any segment of us in our society that's not free? So I'd like to choose one of these quotes, attributed to him, one that I feel is most appropriate for this occasion. He said, our lives begin to end the day we become silent
all right
about things that matter.
Yeah.